In today's video, I want to tell you why you should never, ever trust your pastor. Coming up. Hey guys, my name is Colin, and one of the main goals of this channel is to expose the lies and the deceptions being taught in the church today. Which, if you're unfamiliar with our channel, be sure to go and check out our One Reality films. They go a lot more in depth on what we believe. But today we're talking about why you should never trust pastors whatsoever. More specifically, talking about most pastors in churches today. But let me try to put this in a simple way so that way it kind of makes sense of what I'm talking about here. So let's say you're walking down the street and someone approaches you and they say that they are a criminal. They have committed, tons of different kinds of crimes. They were a really bad criminal. But then they say after that, that they are still a criminal, an active criminal still committing crime. And then they follow up with saying, you have to believe me. Down here in this alley, there's a basement, and in there, there's a little girl who needs help. Will you please follow me so we can help her? Are you going to listen to that person's story and believe them? Or is something going to go like a red flag in your head saying, well, they just told me they were an active criminal, and now they're trying to get me to walk down an alley and into a basement? All the logic and reason red flags are going to be going off in your mind because you're like, they were a criminal, they're still a criminal, and now they're asking me to believe them and lead me, to this place where I could, get hurt or get stuck. Should I really listen to this person? Should I really take that risk? No, I probably shouldn't. See how this person was a criminal and is claiming to still be a criminal. Now, what on earth does that have to do with pastors? Almost every pastor out there in the modern church claims to be a sinner. And most of them have claimed that they have committed horrible sins. And if you ask them right now, they'll claim that they are still an active sinner and that they will be till the day they die. And that they can't stop, committing, these crimes, these sins, and that it's just natural to them to commit sin. They say, oh, it's a sinful nature. I was born a sinner. And so I desire sin. In me, there's this desire to sin, and I fulfill it on a regular basis. I mean, what kind of influence is that upon not only yourself, but your family? This influence that they're telling your kids, you will desire to sin. You're going to desire to do these bad things. You're going to continue to do these bad things till the day you die. I mean, is that even a good example for your children? It's not. Never trust a pastor who claims to be a sinner. Only trust God's word, rely on it, because guess what? It exposes sinners. It says the sinners will be condemned. It says all sinners will have their part in the lake of fire. Paul said, the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God. However, if someone does say that they claim to follow God, they claim to obey God, they claim to live a pure and righteous life, they teach that, and you see the fruit in their life that they are living that, yes, you can rely on that person. You can trust them to a degree, but never, ever be near someone who claims that at any given moment, there could be this desire in their flesh to do something and that they're going to fulfill it. At any given moment, they'll be like, man, I want to shoot up this church. Pull out gun, cling, cling, cling. Well, sorry, my sinful nature, I can't help. I can't stop sinning. There's nothing I can do to stop sinning. It's how God made me. He made me a sinner. I'm stuck a sinner till the day I die. That's why at a lot of these churches, you see a lot of things go down where, the leadership is involved in a lot of bad things with a lot of the kids there, there's a lot of bad stuff that happens. And that's a result of the teaching that you'll remain a sinner till the day you die. And what do you expect coming from someone who is a sinner? They're going to tell you that, oh, it's okay to be a sinner. Though no church is saying, yes, it's okay to sin, obviously they're not going to outright say that. However, when they say that you can sin and you will still go to heaven, that is literally given the green light to sin. It's given the green light. When you tell people that they'll remain sinners till the day they die, that gives them no reason to really put up a fight against it. But that's about all I got for you. Don't get advice from sinners. Don't listen to what the unrighteous has to say about God's righteous book. Just follow what God's righteous book says. You'll never be steered wrong if you just follow what the righteous guy says compared to the unrighteous fool.